Hey YouTube, this is what I think is a superior portable bandsaw stand. Check it out. So I had this idea for a DIY weldable kit that would mount a portable bandsaw to the side of a Fabblock table or fit in a bench vise or kind of mount to whatever bench or weldable, multiple object you desired. I initially drew this up a little while ago and kind of sat on it for a little bit and tried to figure out what I should do with it. I thought about, you know, contacting a couple companies that do laser cutting, and this would fit well into their product line and stuff like that. But after sitting on it for a little while, I decided I would at least have one plasma cut out for myself, and so I took it to the local fab shop. And I drew it up thinking, you know, maybe they would be laser cut out. So my tolerances were a little bit off for plasma cutting. I literally fouled my butt off on this thing trying to get everything to fit. And once I got it all fitting and clamped it up, I slid the saw in there and it fit in there perfectly. So I decided to go ahead and weld it and use it at least as is for me. And, you know, obviously I don't have a fab block, but I'll either mount it to the side of another workbench of mine, or just, you know, leave it loose so I can put it in a bench vise. So it's six total pieces of 3/16. Initially, I had drawn it up for a quarter inch, but I decided this one piece had to be 3/16, and I would go ahead and just make the whole thing out of 3/16. Should be plenty sturdy. I don't feel that you're going to gain too much out of it being a quarter inch, and it'll be, you know, it would be cheaper to ship and make out of 3/16. So I had everything burned out, including these holes here. I had to chamfer them, and I should have just drilled and tapped those, because with the plasma cutting, I had local hardening around all the plasma cut surfaces. So that was kind of difficult to get those holes chamfered correctly or counterbored correctly for the screws here. I have an idea for a quick detach to pull the saw in and out, but you'd use a little bit of clearance height here, and for my purposes, it's perfectly fine taking two screws in and out to remove the saw. So my thought process was, you could mount it, you know, on the side of a fab block here like this, and you have a straight edge. You got a round corner here just so you don't bang yourself on that. And then in the fab block, you can put, you know, one of these, I can't remember who makes these, but one of those in there. These are actually just half inch holes on the corners here, and these are half 13, and you can mount it to your fab block that way, or whatever else kind of nut or nut and bolt system you wanna put in there. So it has this support here, and the saw has a slit that this slides over perfectly to stay true with the slit for the saw blade. In version 2, this will go ahead and extend out further for more support. It did stay flush when I welded it, but there's a little bit more play in that than I would like. So having this extended should stiffen that up. This is the 20 volt, but I do believe the 120 volt wall plug in version has the same body as this. I believe this is it's like 4.5 inches of capacity in this particular saw. So you can mount it any bench vise this direction, as long as the jaws are 5.5 inches or less. And if you had a bigger vise with a deep throat, you could put it in the vise this direction as well. I think that's kind of, for the most part, what I'm going to do with it. That way the saw can follow me around to be closer to where I'm working. This is my preferred method of activating the trigger, and with it being a variable speed trigger, you can adjust your speed using this clamp type clamp as well. Well, let me know what you guys think of these things. You know, I designed it as a DIY weldable kit, but I don't know if the market's there or not. And if you think that think I should pursue finding a laser cutter to produce these, I'd appreciate the feedback. Thanks.